The 40 Hadith of Imam Nawawi. Commentary by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Yaqubi.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد. عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: إن الله تجاوز لي عن أمتي الخطأ والنسيان وما استكرهوا عليه. حديث حسن رواه ابن ماجه والبيهقي وغيرهما. In this hadith narrated by the cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him and with his father, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gives us an example of the licenses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to this ummah. This deen is made easy, and there are various aspects of the easiness of this deen, and this is one of these aspects. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives us what could be considered glad tidings. We all make mistakes. We all forget. And sometimes we get in situations where we have no choice. We're compelled, forced to do something. These are the three cases the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addresses in this hadith. First, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ, Allah indeed, تَجَاوَزَ لِي عَنْ أُمَّتِي, has forgiven my ummah in the following which they may do. First, الخطأ, meaning things done by mistake. Second, things done by forgetfulness. This is النسيان. Third, when people are forced, compelled to do things they didn't want to do, they didn't have free will to do it, this is وَمَسْتُكْرِهُ عَلَيْهِ. Now, by mistake, sometimes people say something. We have a beautiful hadith in Sahih Muslim where there is this man who said in showing his happiness, "Oh Allah, you are my servant and I am your Lord." Because of his repentance was accepted, yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not hold him accountable for what he said because he made a mistake. He wanted to say, "Oh Allah, you are my Lord, I am your servant," but out of mistake, because of being overwhelmed, he made this mistake. Allah will not hold him accountable for it. It's forgiven. The same also, if we make mistakes in this life, these mistakes are forgiven. Second, النسيان, when you forget and you don't do something, or you forget to do something, then you're forgiven. The third category is compulsion, force. When someone forces you to do something, we have the example of Ammar ibn Yasir. May Allah be pleased with him and with his parents. You know that his father and his mother died under torture in Mecca. But he couldn't bear up. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking for a license. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him a license to say whatever he wanted to save his life. So he said something about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in agreement with the disbelievers to save his life. This is after being forced, threatened in another way. His life was threatened. So he's forgiven. He's not held accountable for what he said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ, except who is forced while his heart has tranquility and is full of iman. This is a beautiful aspect which shows us that those who are accountable for their sins are those who do it deliberately, with full intention, without any mistake, without any forgetfulness, and without any compulsion. So we need to be very careful when we opt with our choice to commit a sin against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's rebellion against Him. It is transgression against Him. So one should think a million times before committing a sin. والحمد لله رب العالمين.